It's the longest of the relays on the program, on the Olympic program.
And this is where the juggle act comes in, doesn't it? Because a lot of these swimmers have got big programs to nurse them through the heats. Certainly the Americans are in a position they can do that. They've got such depth. Here's the lineup for the first. And I think the favourites for the gold medal are in this, and that's France. Now, don't say that lightly, and the Americans always are to the fore here, but I think the French have got a good chance.
We see inside the inner sanctum, boys getting ready in the final call room. It is quite a different experience racing with your team members as opposed to racing as an individual. It's a bit more relaxed. And one of the boys looking fairly revved up there.
Is there much byplay between opposing teams?
Yeah, there's a lot of chat in the room normally. You know, in those great rivalry years between Peter van den Hoogenband, Grant Hackett, and Ian, thought they were great mates, you know, and there was always a lot of chat for relays and for individual races. It's almost eye of the tiger once that whistle blows.
The big men out there, they really are the world-class swimmers today. There's the world record, an astonishing 658.55 from Rome. Americans are in the second heat, so
there's only been a breakthrough of that 7 minute mark on two occasions in world swimming. In fact, three occasions. The USA have done it twice and Russia have done it once. So it's a bit of a magic mark, and it was certainly aided by those suits in 2009. So interesting to see what we end up getting for a winning time. Athens in 2004 was 7 minutes and 7 seconds. And then it improved by 9 seconds between Olympics. By Beijing, it was at 6.58.
Right. So much to do with what they were wearing.
Which now there's not that talk of, is it the suit or the athlete's preparation? That's gone away, thankfully.
So the first of the swimmers up to the blocks. So it's Denmark, Hungary, Japan, France, Germany, Italy, New Zealand and South Africa. So from the top, it's Skarning of Denmark, Cosma of Hungary, Kabori, Japan, Stravius, France, Wahlberger of Germany, Maglia of Italy, Stanley of New Zealand, and we know Townsend pretty well. He should be pretty quick from South Africa.
Yeah, Townsend and also Stravius are probably the two biggest names in the lead-off position. The depth of the French team, they'll have plenty of changes to make into the final. And Stravius is doing quite nicely under world record pace. Now, the world record splits you'll see in this race are based off the 4x200 freestyle relay, not the 200 individual.
So the French with Stravius, clear lead at the moment, have established themselves over the South Africans, Japan and Germany. So it's lanes 4, 8, 3 and 5 for the moment. But closing up a little, so long race. 4x200 and France by 3/10 over Japan and 3/10 to Germany. So just repeating, it's Jeremy Stravius of France. He'll lead off. Gregory Millet will take over, then Anne-Marie Laveau and then Clement Lefeur. So the French have got Agnel at least to come in and probably one or two others. So the gap closes. Yuki Kabori may have taken a slight lead here from Japan, though Matthew Stanley's come up, also of New Zealand. He's had a really good third 50. In fact, the New Zealanders now lead from Japan and South Africa.
Takes the lead at 119.64. So there's been a little bit of changing of the lead. Stravius was brilliant underwater, came up just before the 15 metre mark.
So the Frenchman, Nicole talking about there, but he's finding it hard to reassert his authority here, but he's still close enough. So lane 2 from Hungary. Now Cosma's come through, so I think the Hungarians might touch in front here. Here we go, Hungary first. From France, 147.24 was the split, and New Zealand third. So into the water now, from the top is Jonsson of Denmark, Burnek of Hungary, Sodadati of Japan, Malay, France, Filippaev of Germany, DiGiorgio, Italy, Kent of New Zealand, and Basson of South Africa. And it looks as if it's Hungary touching in front. It is. over France and Japan. The margin, not much. It's 2/10 and 3/10.
They need to qualify, quite obviously, and the top eight will go through to the final. But I got the feeling from Stravius's performance from France that maybe they have pre-selected their teams for the finals. Australia, as an example, they will be racing in this heat this morning for those final positions into the relay final. He just didn't have a sense of urgency. 1:48.00 to Stravius in the first leg.
So they're halfway through their leg here. So we're 300 metres into the 800. Hungary leads Japan and France. So for Hungary, Dominic Kosma. For Japan, it's Sho Sotodati. For France, Gregory Millet.
Some great racing going on here. You've got six of the teams within reach of each other. And as we've said, top eight go through. So these swims now, the second and third leg, are all important to try and get some kind of a lead, a psychological gift that you give the swimmer that's coming into the water in the next leg. It's a huge boost.
So the French have come through well. South Africa's had a good swim here too, way out in lane number eight. I think the South Africans, you can see on the left there, they're not far behind. So France leading, Germany has moved through pretty well, and Japan with a black cap still there, and also the Hungarians. So been a really good swim. The South Africans dying just a little. So we get to the halfway point. The French will lead at halfway, and the time is 3:34.98. France, Japan, and Germany. So again, I'll go from the top. It'll be Lyle of Denmark, Jay, the great Jay of Hungary, Ishibashi of Japan, Laveau, we know him very well of France. He's got great speed. Rapp of Germany, Maestri of Italy, Dunlop Barrett of New Zealand, and Russo of South Africa. So they are the swimmers.
The Japanese will have Matsuda to come into their final team. He's ranked in the top few of the world. But Laveau, in this year's rankings, is ranked number 11 in the 200 freestyle with a best time of 1:46.7 this year. So Laveau is a class act and is a very good 200 freestyler. And you just get the feeling that they're racing for that first position. They're looking from left to right, making sure that they are in the lead.
So little between the top six here. There must be less than a second. South Africa, well, look at this, 2 100s between the first three, and then I reckon 4, 5, and 6 are not that far behind them as well.
Well, the potential is that we're looking at these five teams, six teams across the line, that somebody's going to miss out in the final from this very close finish.
I reckon South Africa, closest to us, Nicole, might be in front with Rousseau. So it looks South Africa hungry at the moment. The French have dropped back a bit here, Laveau, so he'll probably kick in the last 50.
The South Africans have Leclerc coming for the last leg, so he's a great 200 freestyler. Gee, they're really putting in a great performance.
And France at the moment is in about fifth or sixth position. White cap middle. Laveau has got high speed, though, and he should be able to come through.
Yeah, we're waiting for that to happen, though, because Lefeur is going to come in for France, and really, Laveau needs to give him something. Now can't have all that pressure on him.
Now coming hard, so has turned on the engines. Let's see who gets there first. And the French still is a good last 50. Germany and Japan, so it's France, Germany, Japan. So Glaister goes for Denmark in one. They're out of it for the moment. Kiss of Hungary, we know he's a strong swimmer, in two. They're in the mix. Horahata of Japan in three. Lefeur of France in four. One of the 4x1 men. Biedemann, the world record holder, Germany in five. For Italy, it's Bellotti in six. McMillan, New Zealand, seven. And Leclerc of South Africa in lane number eight.
Well, it's a good performance, but Germany's not going away either. So lane number five with Paul Biedemann, the world record holder in the 200 freestyle. Missed the 400 freestyle final. He's doing okay from a 200 freestyle point of view, though. He had some good speed in that. He's not letting Lefeur go. And this is a good tactic, because you would think that at least the top two teams now would guarantee themselves a spot, and then the race is on with the rest of them.
And it's Italy leading the rest of them at the moment. So France, Germany, Italy, three big European nations, aren't they?
Big strong boy, Paul Biedemann, world record holder, as I said. Very loping stroke, really holds the water quite well. See how high and how bent the elbow is as they start that pull through. That's where the strength comes. It brings your back and your lats into play, not just your arms doing the work.
And Leclerc doing all right for South Africa. So France by 1100ths over Germany. South Africa get through to third, so they take Germany's place at the moment. Lefeur's come back well on Biedemann here, though. He was very good into the wall, Lefeur.
We're looking at a time around about 7.08 to 7.09. Hopefully they won't drop off too much in the final stages.
Well, they're having a real race here. I think they'll get under the 7.10. And who touches first? Well, France, just from Germany, 7.09. 4.18 the time.
So a good performance if you keep in mind the fact that the Olympic title was won in 2004 at 7.07. They've gone 7.09 in the heats. So a little bit of change to be made to the French team with Amiel to come in. And that will give them a huge boost. Well done to Germany. What they do now is they do make sure that there are no early leaving on the changeovers. So that would come up straight away. There's timing in the touch pads, but also in the blocks. And there's also big poles over the starting blocks, which have cameras in there. So if need be, they review to the photo finish as well. Nothing in it at this stage. France getting a decisive victory of the whole 5 100s in the end.
Is that all, eh? Look at that, after 800 metres of swimming by four different men, that close. Result of the first heat of the men's 4x200, it's France, Germany, South Africa, oh so close at the top, 7.918, 7.923, South Africa, 7.11.51, good swim in Hungary, 7.11.64, Japan, 7.11.74, the top five so close.
So close to those 0.51, 0.64, 0.74. It's quite dangerous for Japan in particular.
Heat two, Russia, Austria, Australia, United States, China, Great Britain, Canada, Belgium. Americans have won everything from Athens on. They won in Athens, they won in 05, 07, they won in Beijing, they won in 09 and 11. They've had a great run in the 4x2. They had that battle in Athens with the Australians, didn't they? Got the better of the Australians, as we see the Australian team there.
And in fact, Australia took the world record for a little while during that Thorpe Hackett era. They had it in 98 through to 2001. And in fact, it stood till 2007 when the USA took it away.
Russia buoyed by their medal in the 4x100. The Austrians, the Australians, now the Americans. So the Americans, we've got Charlie Hatching, Matthew McLean, Davis Tarwood and Connor Dwyer. There'll be some changes, won't there?
Yeah, same too for the Australian team. They have a couple of the youngest members of their Olympic team. It's the local team, Great Britain, David Carey leading them off. Robbie Renwick is their anchor.
And Belgium bring up the eight, and Canada in between Britain and Belgium. China's there as well, in between the United States and Great Britain.
So two of those Australian swimmers as we look at the pre-race preparation. A little bit of psyching out going on, perhaps, of the other swimmers. Two of the youngest boys on the Australian team. Cam McAvoy is only 17. Ned McKendry is around the same age as well. So first Olympic Games, first senior team for those two boys. Big experience for them.
That's for sure. So there's the lineup. Russia, Austria, Australia, United States, China, Great Britain, Canada, Belgium.
No, you're okay. You're not going to get Austria and Australia mixed up.
When you're looking at that, they're close, aren't they? Just one letter, thankfully.
A different cap colour.
On the blocks for the 4x200 freestyle for men, second heat. So off they go. Lobbers off of Russia in one. Brandel, Austria, 2. McKeon, Australia, 3. Hushin of United States, 4. Liu of China, 5. Carey, Great Britain, 6. Worsley of Canada, 7. And Dekonik of Belgium in lane 8.
Lubzov in lane number 1 from Russia is really trying to set a little bit of pace. The ones that go first off the gun, it does count as a time for the 200 metres freestyle. So this is a genuine race time for these boys.
Dave Carey of Great Britain, so he's in the mix as well. Let's see what David McKeon can do for Australia, and Charlie Hoochin of the United States. The USA, such a record in this relay, like every other relay. They are always the team to beat once the entries come in. And they're going to have a narrow lead here. Lane 6 not far away, and lane 3. So USA, Great Britain, Australia, and that time was 52.29.
Good first 100 metre split. Important to try and race your own race. That was a great underwater. Lane number 4, Charlie Hoochin has really put in a good performance leading into that third 50. It's a real focus. Lane number 1 is still holding on as well from Russia.
Lobbers off, we're talking about there. Yeah, Hoochin was great out of the turn, wasn't he? Let's see how he does it here. In he goes.
It'll be that big butterfly kick. No, he does the freestyle kick, big long freestyle kick. Because the boys are so big, they're pushing a lot of water and they've got to get under that wave off the turns.
and a pretty good lead of about 7/10 of a second. Russia and Great Britain were up there. So this is the end of the first of the legs of the 4x2. Russia challenging. Australia coming up as well. Good swim for David McKeon in lane 7, Canada. So who touches? It looks like the United States, but the gap closed. Canada and Australia got within 1/100 and 3/100, and the time was 1:48.22. So from the top, Laganov now of Russia, Schrubel of Austria, McAvoy Australia, McLean USA, Li Yung-Kui of China, Davenport Great Britain, Russell Canada, Sugalus of Belgium.
The Russians are flying in lane number 1. Really good changeover and just a really big sprint. Also in lane number 7, the Canadians with Colin Russell as their second swimmer have got themselves into a great position. Because it's the 200 freestyle relay, it's important though not to overpace yourself in the first 100. Sometimes in the heat of competition that does happen. You go out too fast in the first 100 and then you've got nothing left in the second 100 to give to the athlete that's about to come into the water to finish it off.
Yeah, it must be hard to control that emotion of chasing the person in front. So it's 11 100s between Russia and the United States. Australia 44 100s behind the Russians. And again, the Americans had a good turn there. So it's been a pretty good swim by Matthew McLean. Evgeny Laganov of Russia, Cameron McAvoy of Australia. They're the top three.
The Americans really making their way through the field again. The turn of freestyle, they talk about the third lap being the money lap. This is where you need to make your move. And he's certainly done that, Matthew McLean.
And the margin 6/10. China's come through for third, so the Russians have dropped back. The Brits are sort of just hanging on for dear life, but it's USA.
Good race from the first-time Olympian, first-time senior national team for Australia, Cameron McAvoy. He's a fearless kid, Australian age group champion on a number of occasions, and he's really trying his best out there and doing quite well.
Looks like the Russians have come back a bit in lane number 1, so it'll be USA, maybe Russia. Let's have a look. It's USA, Russia, China. So Australia just died a little, 334.90. So who goes here? Polishuk goes for Russia. Rogan goes for Austria. McKendry, Australia. Tarwater, USA. Zhang of China. Bale of Great Britain. Oriwell of Canada. And Cronin of Belgium.
Well, it's a nice first 50 by the USA with Davis Tarwater. Big high kick, nice straight arms, has a real lope on his stroke with the recovery of the right arm as he breathes off to that side. Look at him underwater. He's cruising a little bit. See, there's a pause in the kick. There it is. It's a timing with his technique, but it's working nicely for him. I have to say, though, with the USA with this margin and the rest of the country is quite close, the race and battle is really on to make this final.
So from the first one, it was 7:09.18 France, Germany 7:09.23, South Africa 7:11.51. They were the top three.
I think the cutoff's going to be around 7:11.74.
Okay, so that's a good time to look for, around about that 7:12 mark. You want to be inside 7:12. Well, the Americans will do that. Australia's sort of in the mix with China at the moment. Let's see who turns second and third. It's USA, Australia, China, but it's a substantial margin here. So been a good swim by Davis Tarwater. He'll give to Connor Dwyer shortly. So Tarwater clearly in front. The Brits have had a good swim here, and that's come from Rob Bale. He's made up a little bit of ground.
Ned McKendry for Australia trains in the same pool as Park Tae-won, so he's also putting in a great performance, really battling to try and get Australia into second, but China is holding on to that.
USA 5:21 the split, China by 3/100 over Australia for second, but they're 2.4 seconds behind the Americans. So from the top for Russia, Sukharov goes into the water. Yanitsin of Austria, Ryan Napoleon, Australia, Connor Dwyer, USA, Dai Jun of China, Robbie Renwick, the big roar for Great Britain, Alex Page of Canada, Peter Timmers of Belgium, USA, Australia, and the Brits get through to third.
Well, look at this gap at the USA. It's a fantastic swim by Connor Dwyer in the first 50 metres. Hopefully he hasn't gone too hard. There's no danger in terms of them not qualifying or winning this, but the USA would be racing for spots in that final team as well. Australia, a good race by Ryan Napoleon, who made the 400 freestyle final on the first day of competition.
It's a big margin, isn't it? So
at 700 metres. The margin's 3.25 seconds. It's a massive margin. USA, Australia, Great Britain, Russia fourth, China fifth, and Belgium, then Canada, and then Austria.
And this performance is a couple of seconds quicker than the winning time for the first heat. So we're looking at a very fast time, probably around about the 7.06 mark, maybe a touch quicker.
But the real interest in the end will be where the two, three, fours, and fives end up here in this one. Massive roar for Renwick, but the USA clearly in front. So
China, with their placing at the moment, China are in trouble, but it is a faster heat, so maybe that might be a saving point for them.
Connor Dwyer way out in front of Ryan Napoleon and Robbie Renwick. USA, Australia, and Great Britain at the moment, with Russia in fourth place. So the USA 7.675, you're right on the money. I think the Australians just out-touched Great Britain, they do. And they'll be the one, two, and the three. China get fourth, Russia get fifth. And behind them, Belgium, and then Canada and Austria.
I reckon China's going to sneak through, finishing fourth in that. Remember I was saying 7.11.74. That was the fifth place for Japan in the first heat. And China have finished fourth with 7.11.35. So I think Japan will just sneak in there. They might be on the outer, maybe ninth. Have to wait for the final results. But here is some of the action from the race. Changeovers are brilliant to watch. They time it to perfection. The Americans do it particularly well because the amount of relay racing that they do through the college system. So for some of them, it's a step forward. One foot would be on the front of the blocks. It's a step forward and a swing of the arms. Some of them hold their arms just out in front, waiting to see the swimmer come through the hole that they've made by holding their arms out. And the traditional rivals, Australia and Great Britain, they're fierce rivals in rugby and cricket. They came down to the wire as well.
Lovely touch there on the ball. So the USA, 7.675. And look at Australia and Great Britain so close, 7.10.50 and 7.10.70. China should get through. Russia, well, 7.11.86. Let's have a look in a moment. We'll see who's qualified for the final.
Keep in mind the Japanese rested Matsuda. He's resting, obviously, for other races, but they took the chance of resting their number one swimmer.
Has it worked for the moment? We'll find out here. It's USA, France, Germany, Australia, Great Britain, China, South Africa, and Hungary. So, wow.
So they miss out Japan by 1/10 of a second. Russia misses out as well after the bronze medal in the 4x100 freestyle. They finish in 10th.